and we descend into the old realms of political goal scoring, then we will also be tempted to say to them that the time when the economy was in psychosis was in 2014 when they took us to the IMF. If we do not rally around a common national agenda to find solutions for our people, then we will also be telling them that insensitivity is when a president looks unemployed young people in the face and tells them that he's not a magician, he can't give them jobs. Mr. Speaker, we don't want to go that way today. We want to have a conversation with a national objective ahead of us. We are here today not to even consider estimates. We are here today not to even do appropriations. We are here to consider the economic policy proposal which the administration has put before us. Mr. Speaker, the question before us is whether or not this House will approve the economic policy. And my suggestion is that this House should approve the economic policy proposals that the administration has put in. Mr. Speaker, additionally, even in the public sector, the government of Ghana, under the leadership of the Akufo-Addo administration, ensured that at least about 300,000 young Ghanaians were recruited in the public sector, both for those who are paid by the Controller and Accountant General and for those from the non-subvented agencies. Yes. Mr. Speaker, this is very different from the days when we were told that because we were down to the bone and had gone to the IMF, we could not recruit people in the public sector. But what is even more exciting, Mr. Speaker, is that in this 2022 budget, the administration has made available 1 billion Ghana cedis to support young men and women in this republic who want to embark upon their own business, known as the Youth Start Initiative. As always, Mr. Speaker, the most important issue on the minds of Ghanaians has been answered by this administration by expanding the private sector. And if you look at the forecast of growth in the year 2022, we as an administration are forecasting 5.8% growth. The International Monetary Fund, from where my friends get policy credibility, says that they project that we'll hit 6.2% growth. That expansion is expansion that will create a lot more jobs in the private sector. The continued expansion in the public sector will create jobs in the public sector. And then the 1 billion Ghana cedis that we are making available to young Ghanaians will also help us create at least about 1 million jobs in the next 3 years in the private sector here in Ghana. And so the most important question, unemployment, is answered by this 2022 budget, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, if you read this budget, it is clear that we are bringing the fiscal deficit down to 7.9 in this 2022 year. We take it down to about 6 and bring it down to the fiscal responsibility limit of 5% of GDP. Mr. Speaker, that is the clearest evidence that this administration is committed to reducing the debt burden on this country. That is a policy that I believe this House must support. Yeah. We cannot in one breath say we want to see a reduction in our debt burden. Yet when we put before you a policy proposal that let us reduce the deficit from 11 to 7.9, you say no, I won't support it. How can that be? So, Mr. Speaker, we must all support this economic policy proposal that says that we want to reduce the deficit from 11 to 7, from 7 to 6, and 6 to 5 eventually during the lifetime of this administration. Yeah. Mr. Speaker, my very final point is that this economic policy before us also proposes a common platform for mobilization of property rates. Mr. Speaker, if you did an audit of how many of us as members of parliament pay property rates and pay what we should really be paying, you may be surprised, Mr. Speaker. We know that property rates are not being collected in the right measure across our country. That is why this economic policy before us outlines a measure by which the central government will collect property rates and use the same property rate to develop our country.